Hey everyone, John Henry here from School of Trade, and today we're going to be taking a look at a short trade on crude oil. It's a wedge breakout trade that we're looking at right now. Crude oil had this really, really strong rise higher pretty much all morning, and it just kind of meandered around for a little while. Took that test of the EMA, bounced right back up again, nice little move higher. But since then, has just got stuck right at this high of day, formed a little bit of a wedge right up at the top up here, or a pennant, depending on how you like to look at it. And I'm taking the breakout of that one. I'm hopping in on the aggressive end of this just because the orders that we're seeing coming in right now are really big. We're getting some heavy, heavy block volume coming in right now on crude oil, and they've been accumulating these highs pretty much all morning. Now, you can definitely wait for a pullback retest of that wedge and then sell it again. I'm opting to get in a little bit more aggressively. Because I'm getting in aggressively, I'm only taking three contracts, but I am splitting them just like I always do, going for the 100, the 200, and the 300 all the way down, and seeing if we can target a little bit of a bigger move here. Now, this move down, we're looking at the first target being at 32 ticks right down here at 8037, the second target 66 ticks away at 8003, and then the third target all the way down to 100 even, a beautiful little dollar move if we can get that move lower. This is kind of what I like to see when it comes to crude oil. You typically expect that 100 tick move on the way down, and I'm hoping that from our entry here we can get that kind of locked in. Now, it is going a little bit slow. Again, they've been accumulating this pretty much the entire time, and it wouldn't be a surprise to see it kind of snap back a little bit, retest that level, and then sell off. But we're in a little bit earlier. You do have the option of adding more if it does come back up there, but right now, I mean, this is pretty much good enough. We're at 80.69, three contracts short. Our stop is up here, 24 ticks away, so 240 at three. Really don't want to add much more just because of the size of the stop. Got to be a little bit more careful. So we're in short right now, 80.69, looking for the first target at 37, second one at 03s, and then if it can break down below those 80s, back down to 79.69. So we'll be back in a little bit, see if we can start getting some of these targets filled. All right, pushing down and beautiful. Got that target filled there. So took one off at 32. Let's get our stop to break even. Bump this down to two contracts. Get that to break even. And we could probably be a little bit aggressive on this and trail this one. I really don't anticipate price coming back this far anymore. So we can bump it up a little bit past break even just to lock in some profit. But we do want to keep it back, you know, behind this candle here, behind this candle here. We don't want to get too aggressive just to see it snap it out and then, you know, drop to our 100 tick target. We don't want to see that happen. So we've got 32 ticks locked in, 32 ticks specifically on the trade so far. Still short from 69, just trailing our stop on the way down here. See if we can get this to fall lower. Now, this has been really parabolic. It's fallen really quickly. So really, honestly, what I'm anticipating is price to come back, maybe even stop us out, but pull back a little bit and then fall back down. Now, that could be an opportunity for a little bit of a reload where you can hop back in short and then just sell it right back off again. Typically, these types of aggressive moves, they don't happen very often, but you know, it could. I mean, you never want to rule anything out. It could just sink straight back down. But this looks to me kind of like what we saw back here, where it shoots right up. You're expecting a little bit of a pullback, possibly reload, and then go right back up to the upside again. So we'll kind of play it by ear, see what it wants to do. But so far, up 32 ticks on the trade, only one contract off, still have two left. That's kind of right where we want to be, honestly. Beautiful trade so far, 320 bucks in the bank. We'll give it some time and see if we can start filling some of these other targets. Next stop, 80.03, and then if it wants to continue, 79.69. All right, we're back, getting some really aggressive orders coming in. Now, because of the buyers attempting to come in right here at 9:30 and then completely failing back to the downside again, I really don't anticipate us coming back to hit that area. So I'm going to drop my stop just above that area there. And, you know, just basically give them a little bit of room. I am obviously being really conservative on my stop. The fact that we've gone so far so quick, you know, we just got a 66 target filled and edging right in on 100. We're tagging this 80 level, which does cause a little bit of an area of concern. Typically around those big round numbers, 80, 85, 90, especially 100, those kinds of numbers, you've always got to be a little bit careful of accumulation volume stepping in. You can see it tested that 80 to the tick, and it's now kind of bouncing up off that level there. So the last thing we want to do is give any of this back. It might even be a little bit more aggressive, depending on how this candle closes. We may lock our stop into, you know, around about 80.30 or so, just above this candle's high. I mean, this candle itself, if we measure from high to low, is 26 ticks. So it's a pretty big candle by itself. But we've already seen the buyers attempt to come in one time down here at these lows and completely fail. They came crashing right back down in easy fills on the way down. So let's adjust our stop here. Oop. Keep accidentally adjusting it again. And look at this, just cracking down lower and lower and lower. Really aggressive move to the downside here. So what I'm going to do, based on what I'm seeing so far, we still got about 2 or 3 minutes left on this candle, but the last thing I want to see is for this thing to come back. So I'm going to just pop it right up here at about 80.28 or so. I don't want to give any of this move back, but at the same time, I don't want to choke the trade out either. That's kind of, again, kind of the last thing we want to deal with. But we're up 80 ticks already on this move. Our stop is locked in at 41. So right now, we're potentially risking giving back about 40 ticks. And that's kind of what you have to do sometimes on these big runners. We've already made more than enough on this trade to the downside just on the two contracts. We've got 66 and 32. We're already at 98 ticks. Almost want to bump this down two more ticks just to lock in 100. But we've got 98 ticks already on the trade, gunning for another 100. If that hits that target down there at 69, we're looking at almost a 200 tick trade. I mean, just a huge move to the downside here. So we'll see if we can get that last target filled. Next stop at 79. 969 stop is locked in at 28, being a little bit more conservative, but still kind of aggressive. But we want to give it some room to kind of breathe before we, accidentally choke the trade out, just to watch it eventually come down and hit our 100 tick target anyway. So we'll be back in a little bit, see if we can get that big runner hit. All right, we're coming back in now, coming back down to these lows, seeing the exact same thing that we saw earlier here at 9:30. Buyers attempting to come in and just getting battered back to the downside again. So I really don't expect price to come back above this little green candle's high, so we'll lock the stop in even closer, 80.11. That actually allowed us to lock in a really nice position, 58 ticks now on our stop. We're still a ways away from our target down here at 69. We came down to 75, and as you can see, I mean, the sellers are just pummeling this price right now. 100 tick target, pretty close now. I mean, the lows are still at 75. Does appear as though some buyers are stepping in there at 75, 74 in that area, seeing some orders stacking up. And they just, every time the buyers attempt to step in, they just get whacked again. Now we're one tick away from our target here. And because of that, I'm going to lock my stop in here a little bit closer. The last thing I want to see is for this thing to reverse on us here. Now, I am still being a little bit conservative. With this aggressiveness, it wouldn't be a surprise to see a little bit of, kind of fluctuation, then a bounce up. But actually, in this case, we get that 100 tick target filled. What a huge move. Look at this pull. I mean, it just, as soon as it cracked out of that wedge, it just absolutely hammered to the downside. Those types of moves you don't see every day. I mean, that's ridiculous. That's a massive fall. Now, at this point, crude oil has reached 100 tick to the downside move, and that actually locked in another 100 on top of the 98. We almost made $2,000 on that trade with three contracts. 198 ticks to the downside, 100 tick move on the downside in crude oil. This is where you expect it to bounce a little bit. And to be honest, with this type of move, I mean, I was expecting it to pull back here, and it came crashing even farther down. So it's going to have to pull back at some point. And the fact that it's now, below the low of day already, the current low of day before that was at 80. So it wasn't really a surprise to see it bounce there, but now we're hammering back down again. I mean, who knows when this thing is going to stop, but we're at the average daily move now of crude oil down here at, I mean, we got filled one tick away from the low, luckily enough, but I mean, this is the average daily move on crude, so it would not be a big surprise, especially after a fall like that, see a little bit of profit taking before it potentially comes back down to those lows again. But that's going to be the trade for today. 198 ticks, $1,980 on the trade. Beautiful short trade, picture perfect example of what a wedge and how you want it to play out. Obviously, they don't all play out that well, but that's how you want them to play out, and just a perfect example overall. So that's going to be the trade. If you have any questions about it, feel free to send an email to School of Trade. Don't forget to check out our trial at schoolofTrade.com, and as always, we'll catch you next time.